Hi, I'm Olivier Blum, the Chief Strategy and Sustainability Officer at Schneider Electric, and it's my pleasure to be with you today to share our sustainability strategy and how it contributes to the growth story of Schneider Electric in the next cycle. As it has been explained by our CEO Jean-Pascal Tricoire, we are an impact company. And an impact company for us is a company that performs, which is really the foundation of doing good. It's a company that impacts all stakeholders in our ecosystem, in all ESG dimensions, but it's also a company that impacts a lot through its business positioning, through the mission of the company. And last but not the least, it's a company that integrates sustainability everywhere in the model, in the culture, in the way you manage a company, from the purpose to the strategy to the execution, from an external and internal governance standpoint, being also included in incentive. And at the end of the day, it's a company that set up a model and a culture to have a very strong impact at the global and the local level. So let me go more in details. We continue to accelerate our commitment to sustainability. And I will start quickly by telling you how we want to lead ESG by example and spend more time in the second part to explain how we have been evolving our business really in the field of sustainability. So 2021 has been an important year for us. First of all, because we've been elected as the most sustainable company in the world by Corporate Knights, but also because we have launched our new strategy for the next cycle. So we have introduced our new ESG strategy with 6 long-term commitments. 5 global commitments in the field of climate, resource, trust, equal, and generation, which are basically commitments we are taking at the global level and where we want really to progress everywhere in the world in all the subsidiaries of Schneider Electric. But because also we believe that the solution to create a more sustainable world is also related to the local dimension and the local ecosystem, we are also asking our local country president to build a local part, and we want to really empower them to build a strong impact for the local communities. So what do we want really to impact as a company? We are committed to address the biggest challenge of our time, which are climate change and social inequality. And that's why we always like in our pledge to have a kind of 10 years, you know, ambition. First of all, on the environment, we want really to make sure we achieve our ambition to be net zero by 2030, in line with the 1.5 trajectory. So we have approved our targets through the SBTi process, but we have also taken a new commitment, a new pledge, which is in the field of diversity to achieve no net biodiversity loss in our operation by 2030. We continue to be very much committed on the social part of our agenda, continue really to empower people across generation and region to create all equal opportunities for all our employees everywhere in the world. And last but not the least, we want to continue to have a very strong impact on governance by continuing to earn the trust of all stakeholders by living up to our principle of trust in the field of ethics, cybersec, safety and quality. So this is really the agenda for us in the coming years, and again, addressing the 2 biggest challenges of our time, which are climate change and social inequality. So starting from this really long-term ambition, what is very important for us is to make sure that we have an impact in the short term on all our stakeholders. And that's why we have been using this methodology of the Schneider Sustainability Impact, where we want to measure basically the progress we are making. We are publishing externally on a quarterly basis the progress we make on those top 11 metrics, which are really the key transformation indicator of the company, but also measuring the local impact with our colleagues from the different parts in the country. And of course, last but not the least, we continue to make external disclosure in the field of ESG in compliance with all the key standards in the market. And we are well on track so far with this ambition by 2025. I'm not going to go into all details on the progress we are making, but what I would like today is to do a deep dive on what we are doing in the field of climate, because it is very important for Schneider Electric in our ESG strategy, but it's also very important on the business side. So, as you know, we have taken an important commitment. We've built a pledge in the past year, which is to become carbon neutral in our entire value chain by 2040. But for us, what is very, very important is what can we do in the short term? And we want to become carbon neutral in our own operation, but we want to go to the next level. We want really to go beyond the scope of our own operation. And this is why in 2021, we have built a massive program to engage our supplier and divide by 2 their CO2 emission. We continue also to have an impact on communities by adding 20 million people in the next cycle will have access to green electricity. We have already achieved in the past cycle 30 million, and now we want to go to 50. And we want, of course, as a result of that, to continue to have a strong impact on the profile of the company by making it greener in order to achieve 80% of green revenue according to our own internal methodology. Last but not the least, we want to have a strong impact in the market, because when you combine all our commitments in the field of climate, I think Schneider will go fairly fast to become carbon neutral in our operation. We hope to have a strong impact quickly on our supplier, but the biggest impact at the end of the day is what we can bring thanks to the solution of Schneider Electric. And here, what we want to deliver in the next cycle is to deliver 800 million tons of CO2 saved and avoided thanks to our solution. That's a natural transition to the second part of my presentation, which is how we want to deliver that. You know the mission of the company, and we have been focusing a lot in the past years on how we could have a stronger impact to help our customers to go through their decarbonization journey. First of all, we are convinced, and I'm not going, you know, after the COP26, I'm sure you are all very well aware about the conclusion, but we all know that we have to go much faster, 3 times faster, in the way we save CO2 emission if we want to be back in line with the trajectory by 2030. We believe at Schneider Electric it's still possible. It requires a lot of effort, but it's still possible, and we've done a lot of extensive survey and working a lot with a large number of customers in the past 2 years. There are 3 key transformations which are required to be back to this really net zero trajectory by 2050. One, it's energy supply decarbonization that represents probably 45% of the solution. 2, process electrification, 30%. And 3, demand optimization. So I'll come back on that later, but we believe technology solutions are available to deliver those savings that will help us to be back on the trajectory. Second point, which is very, very important when we look at the market, we see really the corporate world moving very fast. And you know, it started in 2015 with the Paris Agreement. It was fairly slow at the beginning. But now, as you can see on the chart, in the past 4 years, every year, you multiply by 2 the number of companies which have targets in the field of climate, which are approved by SBTi. We see also the large company moving. 16% of Fortune 500 companies have set targets approved by SBTi. But at the same time, there is 84% who have not done it yet. But the good news is, I would say it's moving. And as Schneider Electric, and I'll come back to that later, we are engaged actually with 50% of those large companies who are really setting up their target in line with SBTi. Now, one good news, strong momentum on the corporate side. One bad news, it's still difficult for corporate to achieve their target. And we have observed in the past 2 years that the common roadblocks are, one, difficult to go through this kind of, you know, complex landscape of reporting and assessment in the field of climate, difficulty for corporate to track energy data and therefore CO2 emission, difficult to engage their ecosystem internally and externally, and bottom line, difficult to structure a program to consider that climate, like any other dimension in a company, should be handled with a strategy, with a plan, with an organization, with a reporting. So based really on this evolution of the market, on the customer side, and what is needed on the climate side, at Schneider Electric, we've came to the conclusion that best-in-class companies do 3 things. They strategize, they digitize, and they decarbonize. So they follow a simple 3-step approach from target setting to execution to be able really to deliver results in line with their climate ambition. And what we have been doing in the past 2 years is really to position Schneider Electric along those 3 dimensions. And we believe today we have a unique value proposition to support our customer from strategy to execution. I'll come back more in detail, but strategize is about basically helping company to define the strategy and the trajectory. So it's basically done through consulting and agnostic consulting. The second part, which is digitize, it's basically about creating a platform where you capture all your energy data and therefore you are able to monitor your CO2 emission. And point number 3, once you have done that, is what are all the solutions that you should implement basically to reduce your carbon emission. And of course, we believe we have a very unique positioning because at Schneider, we can do 1, 2, or 3. We can do both if a customer wants to engage with us at each level, or we can engage with customers at one of the levels depending on their journey and also depending on the maturity of the customer. Let me go a little bit more in detail in each of those steps, and to share with you, more important, some customer testimony. So let me start with a step one, which is really about the definition of the climate strategy, what we call strategize. We've been reinforcing our consulting practice over the past years to help our customer, because as I said before, there are more and more corporations who want really to build their strategy. They don't know where to start. And this is where we come with different solutions depending on the maturity of the customer. But for those companies who start from scratch, it's basically about measuring the baseline, creating the roadmap, structuring a program and governance, but also being able to communicate and to report to the market. Let me share with you one example of Roca, who have been through that journey in the past 12 months.
I'm Carlos Velázquez, Sustainability Director of the Roca Group. The first step of our decarbonization journey was to define who could help us, and it was Schneider Electric. And with them, we defined a holistic vision of what climate action meant for us as a multinational industrial group. Schneider's support was instrumental to help us fully understand our starting point, where are we now, such as measuring our carbon footprint baseline. The next step of the work with Schneider became to develop the decarbonization roadmap, where do we want to go, and define the milestones to reach our future goals through different milestones. Structuring a program by defining and putting in place the right governance, teams, resources, prioritizing the different decarbonization levers has been key to manage our budget and to maximize the return of our actions.
So this example is a very interesting one. Roca is a company that has started really from the beginning, from scratch, and their need was basically to find a partner that helped us to understand really this overall story of ESG carbon strategy, and you understand how we have helped them really to measure and to build the first level of ambition and program. So step one being very important, defining the strategy. Step two is about how you can digitize to create a single source of truth for energy and sustainability data. Let me give you a simple example. Would you imagine a chief financial officer in the world of today being able to do his or her job without a proper ERP where you have all your financial information? We strongly believe at Schneider Electric, this is the same in the world of climate for the future. If you want really to deliver your ambition, your long-term pledge, your short-term ambition to decarbonize your company, you need one single source of truth where you can monitor all your energy data, therefore your CO2 emission, where you have the opportunity thanks to digital services, and we have built over here a lot of knowledge that help our customers to identify opportunity of saving energy consumption. And last but not the least, being able to report your data for internal or external purpose. So we've built over the past year a very strong leading platform in the market, which is EcoStruxure Resource Advisor, where we have accumulated a lot of experience by working with a lot of multinationals, and that make this platform a very powerful platform to help our customers to digitize their information related to climate. What I suggest, let's go through this video to go more in details to understand how EcoStruxure works, but also how it has been used by one of our customers, Marriott.
Resource Advisor provides a single source of truth for an enterprise's energy and sustainability data. Monitor specific energy and resource consumption with access to hundreds of global data streams for comparison, benchmarking, or analysis. This consumption data is also translated into emissions by source, scope, and pollutants to give you your enterprise's global carbon footprint. And dynamic dashboards make it easy for different stakeholders to find the data that they're looking for. The collation and centralization of data from multiple sources, including utility invoice data from vendors, partners, or clients, is automated and managed by our experts with quality ensured. With connected meters and real-time analysis of consumption patterns across facilities or individual systems, energy-saving opportunities now become clear and actionable. And what's more, a broader view of your energy procurement options help you migrate to not just lower carbon, but also lower cost alternatives, helping you stay on top of your progress and performance on decarbonization initiatives and sustainability goals. A single platform to track all your ESG metrics. Consolidated data and reporting templates streamline external ESG reporting. Partner with our consultants for further support. Resource Advisor is here to help you measure, manage, and accelerate your sustainability journey.
So the way Merit International tracks our energy and water and waste and carbon data is through the use of Resource Advisor. So we've implemented that platform, or in the process of implementing that platform, across all 6,200 hotels that we have managed and franchised, to make sure that all of our data is in one single location. Having the right data at the right time has been critical in where we're going with our strategies.
So as you can see, EcoStruxure Resource Advisor is really one single source of truth, where you have all your information and you've understood how it can be leveraged by our customer. Of course, we have a very good example with Marriott, but we have also other implementation, you know, with private equity firms, for instance. We want really to have a very strong implementation of an ESG program with a strong focus on climate that will implement EcoStruxure Resource Advisor in all their portfolio company, and will have the opportunity to consolidate and to monitor their data and to be able to challenge real time all their company in their decarbonization journey. Let's now move to the step three, which is about the execution of your decarbonization strategy. We have identified four levers, and of course, the way to implement it can be very different by segment, by type of customer, depending on the maturity. But we believe that in most of the cases, those four key levers are the ones that will help you to maximize your chance of achieving your decarbonization target. So one, it's about the electrification of the operation. Two, it's about energy efficiency and how you can reduce energy use. Three is about how you can replace some energy source by leveraging more renewable. And fourth, more and more, we believe it's also about how you can engage your value chain. We have a unique portfolio of solutions that can help you to achieve your target. And depending on the customer, that's going to be a mix of all those solutions. Of course, it can start by the electrification of your operation, by leveraging EV solution, by electrifying your process in industry or in building. It could be the installation of microgrid. You could have a strong focus also on energy efficiency by leveraging, for instance, our EcoStruxure Power solution, or all the products that we have that make you more efficient, variable speed drives, UPS, for instance, or our latest AirSet SF6-3 switch gear that will help you to reduce significantly your carbon emission. It's about also, for instance, leveraging the unified operation center thanks to Aveva solution, and so on and so forth. Of course, a big focus on the renewable, helping you really to have access to power purchase agreement to switch to renewable energy. But also more and more, we've seen a large number of opportunities to engage your value chain. And let me give you here two examples. One, what we have been doing with RIB, which is basically the sixth dimension, you know, when you design and you build for sustainability, which is focused on how you can simulate a building at the design stage to make it as efficient as possible from a carbon standpoint. So we are leveraging RIB, we are leveraging ETAP, but also solution with Aveva in the field of industrial software. The one I would like to highlight on this slide is what we have been doing with supplier. And why? Because just to do a deep dive on this one, many companies who have been engaged in their decarbonization strategy realize that the scope 3, it's not all of them, but it's a large number, represent in average 10 times more than their operational emissions. So 10 times more than what they emit in their scope 1 and 2. Usually, they face three major challenges. One, very large number of suppliers in front of them, lack of visibility in terms of data, and lack of internal competency to help suppliers. So what we've been developing at Schneider is an offer that combines all basically the capability that I've explained before to help our customer really to have a strong impact on the emission coming from their scope 3 supplier. So probably you remember that 1 year ago, we've communicated what we've been doing with Walmart around the Gigaton program, which was basically to help Walmart to consolidate all the needs of their supplier, to aggregate their needs in terms of access to renewable PPA. Then we launched, in the framework of our own ESG strategy, the Zero Carbon Project, which is basically what we do at Schneider to help our top 1,000 suppliers to reduce their emission. And recently, we launched the Energize program in the pharma industry with the same objective. Let's hear from one of the leaders of the company in the pharma industry to understand the benefit seen by them.
The Energize program, which was announced at COP26, will really accelerate our internal and external goals, primarily around scope 3, which is all of our extended supply chain. The goal of the program, working with Schneider Electric, and 9 other leading pharmaceutical companies is to really enroll our suppliers, educate them, and assist them in their own electricity and energy requirements, therefore giving them access, removing barriers for them so that they can do more internally, which in turn will make our Scope 3 goals and our overall net zero and net climate impact goals be attained faster and hopefully easier.
Very exciting program. How does it work? Basically, the Energize program, as I said before, gathered 10 companies in the pharma industry. And what we have been doing for them is to create a platform that will offer decarbonization services to all their suppliers. And we call this platform Neo Network, which is a platform Schneider Electric has developed in the past for PPA purpose, and that step by step, we have expanded to offer other decarbonization services. So the supplier, once they access to this platform, they will be able to access to training module, they will be able to access to some solution that help them to measure their carbon emission, for instance, but also to have access to other provider of solution in the ecosystem that we are creating. And how does it work, bottom line? The vision we have is really to create a marketplace for decarbonization solution. So you've understood that we started 1 year ago with Walmart, with a group of suppliers focused on PPA. We extended that with 1,000 suppliers of Schneider, not Energize. And you could imagine in the future that we could add more community of supplier, if some other customers are interested, to have access to this same ecosystem, where basically we connect buyers or people who have a need to go through their decarbonization journey with a very large number of solution providers. We are part at Schneider Electric of those solution providers, but we are also connecting our customer, our supplier in that case, with provider of PPA, for instance, in the field of renewable energy. So that creates a very strong marketplace for decarbonization solution, which is very, very promising in the future. So to conclude, you understand that with our sustainability strategy, we have the ambition to become the preferred partner of corporates at all stages of their sustainability journey. We can engage with our customer in the step 1, 2, or 3. Some of them will engage with us at all level, but what is very, very important, the sooner we enter in the process, the more chance we have, of course, to go through the other part of the journey, which is the digitization and decarbonization. And as you understand, there are more and more corporates who are engaged in their climate transition. And of course, all those decisions are taken at the highest level of the company, and that creates a very, very strong positioning for Schneider Electric at board level, at CXO level, which is excellent for the position of the company in the future. So to wrap up, sustainability is a strong driver for Schneider Electric. You have understood that it's very much integrated between what we do on the ESG side and what we do for our customer. We implement some of those solutions for Schneider. We innovate, we learn a lot. We can bring those expertise to the customer and vice versa. We are also bringing back from all the experience we have our customer, a lot of innovation for our own decarbonization strategy at Schneider Electric. By doing that, we have the ambition to create a very strong agnostic consulting practice and increasing significantly the revenue in the next cycle, continue to grow our digital services thanks to our 2 core digital platform that could create another 15 gigawatt of renewable solution for the market. And last but not the least, it's a very strong accelerator of the growth of our entire portfolio at Schneider Electric, and of course a contribution in our journey to reach 80% of green revenues. And as a result of that, we believe we can have a very strong impact on the decarbonization of our customer by achieving this 800 million tons of CO2 saved and avoided by 2025. Thank you very much for your listening. I'm of course available today or later for any kind of question that you have on our sustainability strategy.